जीसी लियोन में क्या है? ये मैंने मानसून बताया, मानसून में एग्जांपल लिया मुंबई का, ये जनरलाइज है मानसून के लिए। मुंबई में ऑब्वियसली टेम्परेचर कॉन्स्टेंट रहेगा, मानसून, मानसून इन नदर्न हेमिस्फीयर, मानसून इन सदर्न हेमिस्फीयर। हाँ क्या
क्यों होता है
क्या
समर में?
बाद में क्लास के बाद। गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन। सो वी आर डूइंग द एयर मासेस। आई विल क्विकली रिवाइज व्हाट इज एन एयर मास। ह्यूज बॉडी ऑफ एयर हैविंग यूनिफॉर्म टेम्परेचर एंड प्रेशर कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स इज नोन एज एन एयर मास। फाइन। सेकंड, एयर मासेस डेवलप इन द रीजन्स विच आर होमोजेनियस। लिखा कि नहीं हमने? दे डेवलप इन द होमोजीनियस रीजन, मतलब इधर ओनली ऑन द लैंड और वाटर सर्फेस। थर्ड कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ एयर मास, एयर मासेस डेवलप फ्रॉम द रीजन्स विच आर नोन एज सोर्स रीजन्स। होमोजीनियस रीजन्स आर जनरली द सोर्स रीजन्स एंड आफ्टर देयर डेवलपमेंट दे टेक अप द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ द सोर्स रीजन्स। मीन्स दे विल टेक अप द टेम्परेचर, दे मे टेक अप द प्रेशर, दे मे टेक अप द एनी ऑफ द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ द सोर्स रीजन। आफ्टर डेवलपिंग फ्रॉम द सोर्स रीजन they may travel to a different areas under the influence of winds. They may go eastwards under the influence of trade winds. They may go westwards under the influence of westerlies. So when they reach any surface, the temperature of an air mass, if it is colder than the temperature where it arrives, the temperature of an air mass, not temperature of a place, temperature of an air mass is colder than the temperature where it arrives, it is known as a cold air mass. The temperature of an air mass, if it is warmer than the temperature where it arrives, it is known as a warm air mass. Air masses, when they converge, the boundary of two different air masses is known as fronts. What is front? It is a boundary between the two different air masses. That is why we study the air mass. Next, when the air masses do not develop in the equator, why? Because equatorial regions have continuous instability or in unstable conditions, while the air masses require stable condition. Stable condition ki agar kisi ki property leni hai kisi air kisi region ki, then it should remain at a place for sufficiently long time. So stable conditions kabhi bhi high pressure mein honge, not in the low pressure. Why not in the low pressure? Because in the areas of low pressure, if this is a low, air will be continuously rising upwards, promoting instability. But if there is an high pressure, air will settle down, or air settle hone ke baad, it does not go from this place unless pulled by low pressure with great speed. So it remains over the place for sufficiently long period of time. Hence we say that air masses will develop generally in the subtropical high pressure belt, or in the subpolar low pressure belt also fronts will develop, but not the air masses, subtropical high pressure belt and the polar regions. So there are tropical regions, subtropical regions, and there are polar regions of the development of the air masses. Next thing regarding the air masses, the air mass means it has to be stable over the period of time. So when we say air mass has to be stable over the period of time, see, what you should know is, imagine a fridge. Fridge ko aap bar bar khol rahe ho, band kar rahe ho. Will the air inside remain colder? No. But if the fridge is cold, if it has to be cold, it has to remain closed for a sufficient long time. Wahi ho raha hai at large scale with the air mass. Where air mass is continuously moving due to winds, koi air stable nahi hogi and it will not take up the property of the region. But if the air is very, very stable, jaise fridge thanda ho jata hai andar, agar band rahega, to air also will become same like what is the ground. Ground, that is what is the source region. So can I say source regions modify the air masses? Source regions will always modify the air masses. Based on the source region can be maritime, that is ocean. They can be continents. That is, we will classify them with small m, matlab maritime. Small c, that is continental air mass. अब मरी टाइम कैन बी इन द ट्रॉपिकल रीजन्स, सो टी is tropical air mass. It can be in the polar regions. So P is the polar air mass, matlab samandar in the polar regions, or continent in the polar regions. Continent in the tropical regions, oceans in the tropical regions. The air mass can be cold air mass, which is utilized by the small k. We call this air mass as cold. Why we are not using C again here? Because C has already been used in continental. Then we are having W, small w, that is what is known as an warm air mass. Agar air mass comes from sea to the land, it may give rainfall, and rainfall is instability. So air mass can be small u, unstable. Or air mass can be small s, that is stable. Matlab it will promote dry conditions. So based on this, there are 16 types of air masses. And if you can draw this in examination, it will be very good answer. Because generally, ye table koi draw nahi karta, kyunki ye NCERT mein samajh mein hi nahi aata ye table kya hai. But we'll draw this table. So you should know ki the final vacancies kitni hai, that determines also your selection. Is saal 1000 bacche come for interview as compared to last year. 1900 students were only called for interview. 2015-16 mein 3500 students were called for interview. You can understand if the vacancies are lesser, matlab answer has to be even better. So because lesser and lesser people will be called for interview. And so actually the game changer is mains, kyunki itna zyada farak nahi padta interview se. That is meri ek mistake, jo jis isme interview mein acche marks aaye the usme I did not focus on answer writing. So mere se kam jinko marks the mains mein, they got very good marks in interview. And interview I believe chahe hum prepare karo na karo, it is all about whether they like your face or they don't like your face. So whether they like your style, kyunki ek saal 130 bhi milte hai, dusre saal 175 bhi milte hai. Kabhi I know a friend who got 108 that year. Next year same board 72, next year same board, Purushottam Agarwal ka hi board tha, ek saal 108 out of 300, next year same board and he got 242 marks out of 300. एक साल में उसको खुद को नहीं समझ में आया कि उसने क्या ऐसे पर्सनैलिटी चेंज कर दी कि एक साल में इतना ज्यादा डिफरेंस उस बोर्ड को लगा. सो एंड ऑब्वियसली द बोर्ड डिड नॉट रिकॉग्नाइज आल्सो हिम. सो दैट इज व्हाई द रियल गेम चेंजर इज द मेन एग्जामिनेशन. द इंटरव्यू ऑब्वियसली विल डिटरमाइन योर फाइनल रैंक. इंटरव्यू में भी अच्छी तरह से प्रिपेयर करो रादर देन नॉट प्रिपेयरिंग, बट इंटरव्यू इज मोर अबाउट लक. एंड मेन्स के लिए the most important is prelims. So mains mein tabhi chance milega jab prelims pass ho.
Uske liye abhi padhna zaruri
hai. UPSC ke liye waise saal bhar padhna zaruri hai, abhi nahi. To hum bahut kya karte hain, hum bahut sari cheeze wahi cheez bar bar alag alag jagah se karte hain. Yesterday, we generally get impressed by thick books. कि बहुत ज़्यादा information होगा. Information उतना ही होता है. Way of writing is different. Way of presentation is different. So I feel unless there is vast difference in any of the class notes or any of the current affairs का material or any of the material or any of the lectures, you follow only one source and basic books and revise it again and again. So hamare geography ke liye there is no need of buying Khullar, there is no need of buying Savindra Singh for GS. Our notes will be more than enough, and supplement that with NCERT ka ye jo main kuch kuch topics kehta hu, diagrams, it is more than enough. That is aaj jaake complete the climate wala portion, because we are at the end of climatology. बचा है इसके बाद फ्रंट साइक्लोन्स एंड एंटी साइक्लोन्स. एक टेंशन निकल जाएगा कि एनसीईआरटी हो गई 11th स्टैंडर्ड की, you will find only some of the language being different and maybe one or two diagrams being different ya ek do definition extra. Kya karoge? Write that in the margin ya agar bahut cheez extra hai fado us NCERT ko aur chipka do tumhare notes mein. That is the and that will be only the revision. Now when you are doing the notes, air masses humne 3 pages mein likha hai, but for prelims it is not required, so make micro notes out of it. Homogeneous regions, har ek ko apne notes khud banane padenge, because koi HS likhega matlab homogeneous surface, koi likhega same surface. This micro note should be ki it should help you in revision, kyunki micro notes bahut zyada kaam aayenge Indian geography mein. Indian geography is highly factual in nature. So air masses not over equator, source is homogeneous source region, and 16 types of air masses, monsoon kaun se type ka air masses hai, kya hai fronts. So what are fronts? Fronts ka definition, convergence of two air masses, do type ke front hai, cold front, warm front, heavy rainfall, light rainfall, and ye dono mila ke hai temperate cyclone. So isi notes mein, this is what is known as mind map. Cyclone is of two type, tropical and temperate. यहाँ पे एक एक डायग्राम बना दिया. अगर नोट्स की अच्छी अंडरस्टैंडिंग है, डायग्राम में बता देगा लो प्रेशर सेंटर हैविंग एंटी क्लॉकवाइज सर्कुलेशन इन नॉर्दर्न हेमिस्फीयर, और लो प्रेशर सेंटर हैविंग क्लॉकवाइज सर्कुलेशन इन द सदर्न हेमिस्फीयर. सो दिस विल हेल्प यू इन रिवाइजिंग मेनी ऑफ द थिंग्स. अदरवाइज इफ यू फील कि ये बाद में ये नोट्स बहुत ईजिली रिवाइज होंगे, दिस आर नोट्स विल ऑल्सो बी बल्की फॉर यू. फिर भी ज्योग्राफी इज वन सब्जेक्ट विच इज़ वेरी कंसेप्चुअल, ज़्यादा उसमें टेंशन नहीं होता, बट हिस्ट्री में ऐसा करना इज मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट. वेवल प्लान ने क्या कहा, कैबिनेट मिशन प्लान ने क्या कहा, या पॉलिटी में ये बहुत ज़्यादा इम्पॉर्टेंट है. किसको कौन अपॉइंट करता है, कौन रिमूव करता है, किसका कौन सा एज ऑफ रिटायरमेंट है, किसके अपॉइंटमेंट में कौन सी बॉडी है, ऑल दिस फैक्चुअल डेटा. सो या और करंट अफेयर्स के लिए भी ये माइक्रो नोट्स बहुत काम आएंगे, बट करंट अफेयर्स का माइक्रो नोट्स का तुम्हें एंड में मिलेगा, इंस्टीट्यूट से सब मिलेगा बट एंड में मिलेगा. अब एंड में कितना आप रिवाइज कर पाओगे, दैट विल डिपेंड ऑन हाउ मच कोर सब्जेक्ट्स यू हैव कवर्ड राइट नाउ. एंड के लिए इकोनॉमी छोड़ दिया, पॉलिटी छोड़ दिया, तो यू विल नॉट डू करंट अफेयर्स. और करंट अफेयर्स अभी करोगे और यू विल थिंक कि मतलब करंट अफेयर्स इफ़ यू फोकस टू मच राइट नाउ and you leave the core portions behind, then it will not make that much sense, because this current affairs anyways that is so factual ki baad mein revise karna padega. So proper balanced studies ki current affairs thoda bahut kar liya din mein 1 ghanta, nahi to inside se bhi dekh rahe ho, yahan se bhi dekh rahe ho, vision ka bhi dekh rahe ho, forum IS ka bhi dekh rahe ho, aur ek YouTube ka video bhi dekh rahe ho, and aise 5 ghante ja rahe hai current affairs mein, consolidate kuch nahi ho raha hai. So it will not make any difference. You, that videos are very good. Every source is good of current affairs. The videos are also very good, provided उस video का आपके पास notes है, because रोज 1 घंटे का video है. So will you be able to revise at the end of a month 30 hours of video? So after the end of 3 months 90 hours of videos, after the end of 4 months 140 hours, 120 hours of video? No. So you should have something written in only your format. So try to make micro notes of the topics as much as possible, whether it is current affairs, and everyone will have to make their own notes, because your notes, micro notes are understood only by you. So you can go, Vinil Krishna ke aaj bhi notes hai market mein, he is a 6th ranker har subject ke. Micro notes of many toppers are available in this market. Try reading them. Khareed to loge aap, ट्राई रीडिंग देम, कुछ समझ में नहीं आएगा. तो उससे अच्छा खुद से ही नोट्स बनाओ, माइक्रो नोट्स, एंड दैट विल कीप यू डिसिप्लिन्ड ऑल्सो. ऐसा लगेगा अभी कुछ नहीं हो रहा है, बट मे में यू विल सडनली रियलाइज कि यू आर मच मच अहेड ऑफ द कॉम्पिटिशन, बिकॉज यू हैव वर्क स्लोली. वो कछुए वाली बात हमेशा याद रखना, हम ऑलवेज रिमेंबर द टॉर्टॉइज, ही कंसिस्टेंटली वर्क्स एंड विन्स द रेस. ऑन अदर हैंड रैबिट, rabbit thinks he is very superior, he is very intellectual, he modern India ki basic books ke badle wo Basham padhne lag jata hai, Bhasham complete hi nahi karta. Then rather than doing the NCERTs, he takes very hi-fi books, searches the internet, does the YouTube ka video. So friend circle mein bahut zyada ki अरे वाह कितना नॉलेजेबल है. सो और ही गेट्स अ पॉजिटिव रिस्पॉन्स एंड ही विल कीप ऑन वेस्टिंग द टाइम. अल्टीमेटली 2 जून को द फॉल डाउन. सो दिस इज व्हाट देयर विल बी 16 टाइप्स ऑफ एयर मासेस. सो बेस्ड ऑन द 16 टाइप्स ऑफ एयर मासेस वी विल जस्ट सी दिस. Diagram is given even in the NCERT, but you will first understand what this diagram is. So what are the 16 types of air masses? So we can classify the air masses into tropical air mass, whether it develops in the tropics, capital T, or we can classify them into, what is dusra air mass? Polar air mass. That is developed into capital P. Now this tropical air mass can be further divided into whether it develops on the marine surface or whether it develops on the continent. So can I say maritime tropical small m capital T and continental tropical air mass CT. Similarly, the polar air mass can be further divided into maritime polar air mass and continental polar air mass, CP. Fine? Keep a blank page, ye bada diagram hoga. Maritime tropical air mass. Can be further, depending upon the area it visits, maritime tropical warm air mass or maritime tropical cold air mass. Similarly, continental tropical air mass can be continental tropical warm or continental tropical cold. Maritime polar warm, maritime polar cold. Continental polar warm, continental polar cold air mass. Fine. Up this warm air mass, tropical warm air mass, if it is originating on the land and goes towards the sea, it does not have moisture, so it will not give rainfall. But if it is coming from sea to the land and it is forced to rise up due to mountain barrier, it already has moisture, it will cool and it will give the rainfall. So can I say maritime tropical warm air mass can be further classified into maritime tropical warm stable if it does not give the rainfall and maritime tropical warm unstable air mass. Understanding this, everyone? Stable and unstable. Maritime tropical cold stable, maritime tropical cold unstable. Continental tropical warm stable, continental tropical warm unstable. Continental tropical cold stable, continental tropical cold unstable. Same maritime polar warm stable, maritime polar warm unstable. Maritime polar cold stable, maritime polar cold unstable, continental polar warm stable, continental polar warm unstable. क्या है, हम वार्म को वेदर इट इज गिविंग रेनफॉल और नॉट गिविंग द रेनफॉल. कॉन्टिनेंटल पोलर कोल्ड स्टेबल, कॉन्टिनेंटल पोलर कोल्ड अनस्टेबल. हाउ मेनी टाइप्स ऑफ एयर मासेस? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 और 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. There are, these are the 16 types of air mass. कुछ रटने की जरूरत नहीं है. Understand the concept. W. So what will be this importance of this air masses? If the stable air mass goes into the area, it may give, it may promote dry conditions. If the unstable air mass comes, it may promote wet conditions. Agar colder hai to snowfall, wet conditions mein. Agar warmer hai to rainfall. Dry and warm hai to heat waves. So these are the kinds of the air masses that will come in a region. Fine with this? Give me a minute. मैं क्लास में हूँ. मैम का फोन आया था. मैम को बोलना मैं क्लास में हूँ शायद. आफ्टर द क्लास. Fine with this? So now you can say air mass मतलब क्या है? Nothing but complication of a subject. क्योंकि वैसे practically कुछ utility नहीं है इसकी. This is just to predict the rainfall, to predict the future climate. कि हमने चीजों को जो है, देखो जो एक बड़ी हवा है उसको हमने areas में break कर दिया. उस areas में break करके किसी को नाम दे दिया local wind, किसी को नाम दे दिया regional wind, किसी को नाम दे दिया rainfall. Depending upon the kind of an rainfall, अगर rainfall is very less, उसको ही हमने नाम दे दिया drizzle, to make things easy for us to understand. So similarly, if an air is very big in an area, Indian Ocean के ऊपर की air, neither you can call them winds. Why? Because winds only are at the surface, but air is a three-dimensional concept, so you will call it as an air mass. Getting it? So that is why we have come with the concept of an air masses. अब एयर मासेस का कंसेप्ट हैज बीन निगेटेड वैसे वर्ल्ड लेवल पे. ये पुराना कंसेप्ट है. नो लॉन्गर इन द बुक्स विच आर प्रॉपर बुक्स ऑफ ज्योग्राफी जो फॉरेन ऑथर्स लिखते हैं, यू विल नॉट फाइंड एयर मासेस मेंशन देयर. बट इंडिया में आज भी एयर मासेस पे क्वेश्चन पूछा जाता है. बिकॉज एयर मासेस से बेटर कंसेप्ट इज जेट स्ट्रीम. दैट इज वी हैव, दिस इज द न्यू कंसेप्ट, बट स्टिल दे विल आस्क यू अबाउट द एयर मासेस. एग्जाम्पल लास्ट ईयर. So generally whatever the question that came in the mains last year, उसके basis पे, remember these are the tricks, क्यों कुछ लोग prelims यूं pass हो जाते हैं. जो पूछा जाता है पिछले साल prelims में, mains में, उसके लिए वो prelims के लिए prepare करके जाते हैं. So air masses can come in the prelims near examination this year. जो questions prelims में पूछते हैं वो क्वेश्चंस मेंस के लिए प्रिपेयर करके जाते हैं. दैट इज 2 जून पे इफ एनी टॉपिक इज आस्क इन द प्रिलिम्स, उसका दे विल मेक क्वेश्चन आंसर एंड गो फॉर द मेंस. सो इन दिस वे इफ देयर आर सम, एंड जितने भी पास्ट ईयर प्रिलिम्स के क्वेश्चन है वो रट के जाते हैं. एग्जांपल बुद्धा वाला क्वेश्चन, You look at the year 2014, what are the places that Buddha visited? Kisi ko pata nahi. Just 3 days before the preliminary examination, UPSC releases the answer key. There are some students jo answer key ratke jate because unko ye rehta hai ki why I made the mistake. So answer key wo ratke gaye. And 2015 mein, 6 questions of 2012, 13, 14 came as it is in 2015 ka preliminary examination and Buddha ka question to without changing the option also. So 2015, I remember because that was the era, that was the time when we had won a court case in the lower court regarding there was some issue with UPSC ka final result. So we had put a court case, it is the most famous court case. And because of that court case, at least UPSC answer ki to dene lag gayi. And it has started giving you kitne prelims mein right hai, kitne prelims mein wrong hai. Before 2012, you see, kabhi nahi aata tha. So, in that court case, last moment pe we won in CAT, Central Administrative Tribunal. And because we won in the Central Administrative Tribunal, kahan pe we, most of the, there were 30 students, all of us, we had filed in the CAT of the Allahabad. So, we got a center 6 days before the exam, when we won the case, 6 days before the exam, UPSC allowed us to write. Jab court ka hai, to UPSC kaam hai ki aapka form bhara ke lena, ye sab karna. Court ne bola, allow them to sit in the prelims. Obviously, we were not eligible ki online hum form bhar paaye. So, I saw that day court ka power. 5 phone from UPSC. I did not pick up. He, please form bharo, please form bharo. So when I said that, when some of the students, including me, said that we are at different places, aap se sign or photo bhej do, hum form bhar denge. So they wanted to make sure that they should not come into contempt of court, ki inko examination mein kyun nahi bithaya. So the forms were filled by UPSC till the one day before the exam. There was one student who was out of India, he came to India, he filled the form. Fir usko kaun dega hall ticket? There was a person from UPSC standing at the center, taking his all ticket, ki yellow print out, and plus, please go and sit the examination. So, this is the power of the court. And remember, CAT is the lowermost court. This is not even high court, this is not even Supreme Court. So, we filled, we went to Allahabad. All of us were given the same hall, ek to Allahabad mein. And there were many students, most of them were working, koi state services mein tha, koi teaching mein tha, koi private sector mein tha, because 3 saal baad jab attempt milta hai, obviously you are not going to wait for 3 years. So in that time, out of this 30 students who were there, 29 students cleared the preliminary examination us hall mein se. Kyun? Kyunki sab experience the, sabko pata tha ki kya karna hai last moment mein. I remember I filled the form of 12th of June and 22nd June ko exam tha. उससे पहले हमें पता भी नहीं था हमें अटेम्प्ट मिलेगा कि नहीं, बट वी कुड ऑल क्लियर द एग्जामिनेशन. हमारा, इफ यू गो एंड सी द 2015 का रिजल्ट, हमारा रोल नंबर अलग ही है ऊपर कि ये स्पेशल कैटेगरी है. सो 10 लाख 1 to 10 लाख 31 स्टूडेंट्स वेर देयर. ऑब्वियसली मेंस में हम लोग हार गए, वी लॉस्ट इन हाई कोर्ट, वी लॉस्ट इन सुप्रीम कोर्ट, बिकॉज जो हमारा वकील था, ही कुड नॉट argue properly. Why he could not argue properly? Because CAT tak to normal lawyers the. When we went to Supreme Court, High Court, hamara vakil normal, sabne 5-5, 10-10,000 rupay jama karke, jo 30-31,000 mein, matlab jo bhi 3 lakh mein jo vakil kiya tha, aur uske khilaaf tha Solicitor General of India, Advocate General of India. So with the battery, obviously judge bhi dekhenge ki ye kaun hai. So last में तो हमें जज ने बोला, सुप्रीम कोर्ट के जज ने बोला कि एटलीस्ट सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने हमारी केस तो ले ली, नहीं तो when I went to Supreme Court, I saw how Supreme Court treats the cases. Any case? What is this case? 2 minutes 30 seconds the lawyer will speak, and if judge does not like it, fake देता है file. Don't bring such cases. Fine on you. They literally throw the files away. At least we were heard. Last में the judge, what was there, judge said that, see, we know that there are many discrepancies in UPSC, but we don't want to open the Pandora's box. Pandora's box means we don't want to open this problems. Otherwise, because for some for better public good. So for better public good, if a small minority of the population suffers, it is fine. So that was the and but it usne UPSC ko data and bola ki make your processes more transparent. Tell what is the scaling, how you try to manage so many optionals. Kisi optional mein upar ka marks, kisi optional mein niche ka marks. And it said that RTI mein paper khule karo mains ke. Jisko UPSC ne mana kar diya, saying that if RTI mein paper open hota hai, to coaching institutes wale hamara marking pattern samajh jayenge and they will make a use of that marking pattern. So even that is fine, we can understand that. So all this made, and the last made, the court, the judge also said to the students, it's fine, it's a phase of life, you go and find, do something else. So UPSC hua nahi hua, you do something else, etc. So what I learned from that is, see, it's not easy to fight large institutions, because CAT mein hum jab jeet gaye the, always the judge who was favoring us, and remember, I can say this on record, that means it is totally true. So all the judges that were favoring us, they were transferred. It is not easy to fight a big organization such as Government of India. High court mein ho sab nahi, because why we lost? Because final judgment of CAT was not in our favor. Why the final judgment was CAT in not in our favor? Because three judges who favored the students, they were changed. Why they were changed? Because CAT is appointed by DOPT. It is not under high courts. And DOPT is an administrative body. Tribunals are under DOPT, Department of Personnel and Training. And that time we realized that UPSC is not as powerful as it is meant. Hame lagta hai. UPSC se powerful is DOPT. UPSC is always favor the students, because hame jo inside information sab milti thi ki aise court case lado, aise hoga, it was all done by UPSC. UPSC always thinks for students. Ye jo mechanism jo baitha hai DOPT mein, who are at very senior level, unko ground realities pata nahi hai. They make the rules and UPSC will just implement the rules. The only thing they have made sure is they will not interfere in UPSC. Because we saw one thing, that when UPSC ka lawyer used to be absent when there was hearing, yeah, he used to be present and he used to keep silent. Oppose karta tha sirf DOPT ka lawyer. UPSC bahut bar apna lawyer bhejta hi nahi tha, because UPSC also realized that 2011, 12, 13 and 14 there had been large scale discrepancies and itna zyada uncertainty thi ki many people suffered from that. Syllabus change hote gaye, marking pattern change hote gaye, papers change hote gaye over the period of time. It was so much unsure. Why? Because one person who was a UPSC chairman wanted to make this body technocratic. Technocratic, usne socha ki humanities wale students are not that efficient enough jitne engineers hai. And therefore CSAT laya gaya. CSAT also came with an agenda that elite should be there in the body, because ek elite bureaucracy ek elite samajhta hai. That is an, you can say, bureaucracy is Brahmins and state services are. So my uncle, who is now a promotee state service officer, so he says one simple thing, that direct IAS are like swans and promotee IAS are like ducks. Keechad mein swan bhi rahega, that is the Rajhans, and duck bhi rahega. But Rajhans kabhi ganda nahi hoga, and hamesha blame duck ko kiya jayega, kuch bhi agar ganda hua to. So what he means to say, this is, there is an elitism. And isiliye there was saying that maybe speculation ki CSAT laya gaya, it's many people suffered out of that. And फिर जब लबासना ने कहा कि CSAT is such a wrong pattern of judging the students, and plus यहाँ पे there was large scale violent protest हुए थे, उसके बाद UPSC removed the CSAT, gave one compensatory attempt in 2015 to the students who had appeared in 2011. People like me had filled the form of 2011, which was my last attempt, but हमारे time इफ द संडे में एग्जाम है तो इंटरव्यू का रिजल्ट्स यूज्ड टू कम ऑन सैटरडे नाइट 8 o'clock. अभी तो बहुत रिफॉर्म्स आए हैं ओवर द पीरियड ऑफ टाइम. सो व्हेन दैट ऑब्वियसली संडे में न्यू पैटर्न्स है एग्जाम है सडनली सी सैट, उससे पहले ऑप्शनल था. एंड इफ आई हैविंग एज, सो बहुत सारे लोगों ने 2011 का अटेम्प्ट स्किप कर दिया था जिनका लास्ट अटेम्प्ट था एंड वे आर हैविंग एज. उनको क्या पता था कि 2015 में उनको कंपेंसेटरी अटेम्प्ट मिलेगा. दैट इज वी हैड फॉट द केस एंड अभी भी केस जा रहा है, चल रहा है ऑन द बेसिस दैट 2011-15 में यू कैन नॉट से कि जो बैठे थे एग्जाम में उनको दो अटेम्प्ट. अगर देना था तो जिन्होंने फॉर्म भरा था उनको सबको देना था, नॉट इन जिन्होंने बैठे थे, बिकॉज नोबडी न्यू दिस एंड दैट केस वॉज स्टिल गोइंग ऑन एक्सेट्रा. आज भी कभी कभी कोई ये कहता है दैट इज द टॉप फंक्शनरीज ऑफ RSS, क्योंकि हमें अटेम्प्ट एक ही बॉडी दिला सकती है, नॉट गवर्नमेंट, RSS. सो द टॉप फंक्शनरीज ऑफ RSS से दैट अटेम्प्ट कैन बी गिवन ओनली ऑन वन कंडीशन, इफ वी वॉन्ट टू रिड्यूस द एज लिमिट. सो एक 3-4 साल के लिए सबको फ्री अटेम्प्ट दो एंड रिड्यूस द एज लिमिट. सो आज नीति आयोग का रिपोर्ट आया है विच सेज दैट मेक द एज लिमिट 27 फॉर सिविल सर्विसेज. ऑब्वियसली जो होगा नहीं, बिकॉज द प्रेजेंट गवर्नमेंट इज टोटली अगेंस्ट गिविंग एक्स्ट्रा अटेम्प्ट एंड इट इज़ वेरी ऑब्वियस. बट आई लर्न वन थिंग कि गवर्नमेंट से गलतियाँ होगी, आपके नसीब में नहीं होगा, यू मे नॉट गेट सिलेक्टेड, देर विल बी सम मिस्टेक्स कमिटेड बाई इंस्टीट्यूशंस. फॉर एग्जाम्पल वन ऑफ आवर केस, वन ऑफ आवर फ्रेंड, ही इज टू स्टे इन दिब्रूगढ़. ही सेंट 1 month बिफोर द फॉर्म, पोस्टल पोस्ट से भरा जाता था बाई स्पीड पोस्ट, बट दैट फॉर्म पोस्टल डिपार्टमेंट ने गलती से वो फॉर्म कभी UPSC पहुँचा नहीं. जब वो वापस आया तो उसका फॉर्म रिजेक्टेड था क्योंकि वो लेट पहुँचा. फॉट अगेंस्ट द पोस्टल डिपार्टमेंट एवरीथिंग, बट सब जाके ये सुप्रीम कोर्ट में हार जाते हैं. इन द एंड पीपल आर गोइंग टू जज यू और द इंस्टीट्यूशंस ऑल्सो जज यू, नॉट बाय क्या हुआ आपके साथ, नसीब में था, हमारी गलती थी या नहीं गलती थी. दे आर गोइंग टू जज यू बाय वेदर यू क्लियर द एग्जाम और वेदर यू डोंट क्लियर द एग्जाम. सो डोंट वरी अबाउट दिस, इतना सारा हार्डशिप्स और इतना सारा इसका चांस ही मत दो. बेटर देन दैट, जब बेस्ट टाइम है स्टडी, और बिकॉज द टाइम कीप्स ऑन चेंजिंग. व्हेन आई वाज डूइंग, व्हेन द कंडीशन वाज वेरी गुड, बिकॉज सेकंड अटेम्प्ट में ही मैं इंटरव्यू में गया था 4 attempts में से. दैट वाज द, चलो तब इंटरव्यू में बहुत कम आए थे बिकॉज इंटरव्यू पता नहीं थी. एंड दैट टाइम द वैकेंसीज वेर ऑल्सो समवेयर अराउंड 480 वैकेंसीज. सो बट इन द थर्ड अटेम्प्ट वॉज माई बेस्ट अटेम्प्ट एंड आई शुड हैव इम्प्रूवड ऑन दैट third attempt, but I did not improve because I thought on focusing only on preliminary exam and answer writing. मैंने किया नहीं, मैंने बहुत सारी बड़ी बड़ी books पढ़ी, but what happened in the end कि mains में मुझे marks, जब mains interview में जब मुझे अच्छे marks आए तो mains में मुझे बहुत खराब marks आए. I was just 10 marks above the cutoff. Because I could not complete the paper, not because I did not knew the answers, only because I could not complete the paper. I left somewhere around 60-70 marks in optional paper 1 and 40 marks in optional paper 2 and 70 marks in GS. So total this 200-150 number come. And jab maine writing practice kam ki to fir my luck did not favor me in interview. He gave me only 130 out of 300. So you should always, aur bolte bolte aise attempt khatam ho jate, you should always, abhi to 6 attempt hai, you have much better chances, but age is also increasing. Getting it? So don't worry about the institutions, kya change ho rahe, kya nahi ho rahe, because government will never accept uska mistakes. Mistakes is always of the person who fails. एंड जो सक्सेसफुल है उसके कभी मिस्टेक्स नहीं गिने जाते. सो केस वॉज फाइल बिकॉज एसए के मार्क्स, बहुत सारी चीज है, देर आर न्यूमरस केसेस, बिकॉज देर आर पीपल जिनको 200 में से एसए में 6 मार्क्स मिलते हैं. क्या है ये? टाइपोग्राफिकल एरर, 60 के बदले 6 आ गए, या 12 मार्क्स मिल जाते हैं, 126 के बदले 6 आ गए. उनको असली मार्क्स पता भी चल जाते हैं, बट कोर्ट रिजेक्ट सेइंग वी डोंट वांट टू ओपन पंडोरास बॉक्स, क्योंकि एक को रीइंस्टेट कर दिया तो देन ऑल द पास्ट केसेस विल ओपन. बिकॉज गलत सही नहीं होता, वही मैं आप भी समझा रहा हूँ कि गलत सही नहीं होता. इट इज ऑल अबाउट चाणक्य नीति. दैट इज वॉट इज वन हु विंस इज द सक्सेसफुल. दैट इज देर इज नो गलत सही. बिकॉज एक आदमी के लिए दे डोंट वॉन्ट टू स्टॉप द प्रोसेसेस, अदरवाइज स्टेट सर्विस बन जाएगी यूपीएससी. 3 साल कोर्ट केस ही चल रहा है. So you can take down the so so you can take down that the air masses modify the surface temperatures, the weather conditions, modify the weather conditions of the areas they visit. This air masses pick up the characteristics, this air masses pick up the characteristics, that is temperature, pressure, and humidity from the source regions, temperature, pressure, and humidity from the source regions, and modify the weather conditions full stop. For example, warm air masses from the tropics influence the temperate regions by increasing the temperature influence the temperate regions by increasing the temperature. For example, British type of climate, इस एग्जाम्पल का एग्जाम्पल British type of climate is an outcome of weather conditions of maritime tropical warm unstable air mass. British में कभी भी बारिश होती है, temperature increases. क्यों? क्योंकि ट्रॉपिक से एयर जाती है. नेक्स्ट पॉइंट, द एयर मासेस are taken from the source regions under the influence of permanent winds such as easterlies and westerlies. थर्ड पॉइंट, इसका मतलब है कि एक बार अगर सपोज यहां पे ओरिजिनेट हुआ एयर मास इन द ट्रॉपिक्स, तो वेस्टर्लीज उसको वेस्ट की तरफ ले जाएगी, अगर ट्रेड विंड है तो उसको ईस्ट की तरफ ले जाएगी. थर्ड पॉइंट, air masses are most significant. Air masses are most significant because they help in the formation of fronts. They help in the formation of fronts. Help in the formation of fronts. Fronts underline karo. Formation of fronts. Full stop. And fronts. Are the regions where temperate cyclones originate. Fronts are the regions where temperate cyclones originate. Temperate cyclones originate. Full stop. Temperate cyclone ko bhi underline karo. Now for prelims only. Which air mass is Indian monsoon? Southwest monsoon is which air mass? Khudi ko pucha whether it is tropical or polar. Tropical. So we will come here. Whether it is coming from marine or continent? Marine. So we are coming here. Whether it is warmer or colder? It is warmer. Why it is warmer? Because though the rainfall ke baad the winds become colder. Understand? The winds which are coming are much, much more warmer because they are carrying the latent heat of Arabian Sea, which is very hot, or the Bay of Bengal, which is very hot. Then they come to India, then they give the rainfall, and uske baad the ground becomes colder. Barish ke baad ground becomes colder. Barish se pehle bahut zyada garmi hoti hai. So therefore, it is an example of a warm air mass. Stable or unstable? So this is nothing but southwest monsoon. This is nothing but southwest monsoon. Maritime, tropical, warm, unstable air mass. Why I have written this in red color? Because ye bhi ek air mass hai, but it is not important for us right now. But there is one air mass which will give rainfall, but it is much, much colder as compared to the other area. But wo Madagascar wo sabko influence karta hai, not in India. So this is for India. Maritime, tropical, warm, unstable. So कैसे आएगा क्वेश्चन? एक तो डायरेक्टली आएगा मैरीटाइम ट्रॉपिकल वार्म अनस्टेबल, या दिस आर इंटरनेशनली रिकॉग्नाइज्ड शॉर्ट फॉर्म्स. क्वेश्चन कैन बी MTWU आल्सो. सो मैरीटाइम ट्रॉपिकल वार्म अनस्टेबल. राइट नाउ वी आर इन विच टाइप ऑफ क्लाइमेट? विंटर सीजन. सो इज इट अ ट्रॉपिकल एयर मास और इज इट अ पोलर एयर मास? अभी अभी हियर दिल्ली में पोलर से आ रही है विंड, या इट इज कमिंग फ्रॉम हिमालयाज ओनली? Himalayas. So Himalayas at the poles or at the tropics? Tropics. Is it maritime? Is it continent? Continent. Is it warmer or is it colder? Colder. So is it causing rainfall or no rainfall? No rainfall. Rainfall western disturbance se aate hai, not due to this air mass. So this is winter. मरीन, क्योंकि वो मरीन से चेंज होते जाएगा. ड्यूरिंग विंटर्स, नॉर्थ ईस्ट मॉनसून ड्यूरिंग विंटर्स. सो आई विल गिव यू, मेरे को अभी याद नहीं है पास्ट ईयर क्वेश्चन, पिछले साल का ही पास्ट ईयर क्वेश्चन है. यू कैन गो एंड सी व्हाट दैट क्वेश्चन वाज रिगार्डिंग द एयर मास. लिखो उसको एंड कीप योर आंसर रेडी. Stable because it does not have moisture. Yeah, it has moisture but comes over the cold surface, and because it comes over the cold surface, it is forced to come down. Then no rainfall. Anything that does not give rainfall is stable. Fronts. Now, what do you mean by fronts? Front, understand, is a sloping boundary. Don't write here, first understand. Sloping boundary. Kiske beach sloping boundary? Where do we find the fronts? In the regions jahan pe, there is a cold polar easterlies and warm westerlies. Sloping boundary between two contrasting air masses. Which diverge or which converge? Which converge? Converging air masses. Why we say sloping boundary? Imagine this, there are two kinds of air. One is the warm air and the other is the cold air. So if this is our ground and the warm air is coming into the regions of an cold air, or the cold air is coming into the regions of warm air. Suppose this is a cold air and this area is a warm air. When the two mix with each other, hamare ghar ke jaisi conditions nahi hoti ki baju ki room thandi hai aur ye room garam hai to darwaza khol do AC ki hawa aa jayegi. Ye sirf chote level pe hota hai. At the larger scales, when the two air masses mix, when they mix with each other, when they converge, unka temperature moderate nahi ho jata. The cold air picks the warm air and throws it upward. So as a result of this, if we consider the cold air and the warm air, what will happen to the cold air? The cold air will try to settle down and the warm air will go upwards. So this is the warm air which will go upwards, and as a result of this, the warm air will go upwards. As a result of this, we find ki ek boundary ban jata hai between the warm and the cold air, and we call this sloping boundary as fronts. हाँ क्योंकि ठंडी हवा गर्म हवा ऊपर रहती है तो winds एक ही है air mass and winds. Winds only at the surface. If we take three dimension, it is known as air masses. क्यों करते हैं three dimension? Because जब तक three dimension नहीं करोगे, you will not understand the concept of polar vortex और जेट स्ट्रीम्स. जेट स्ट्रीम्स कब समझ में आता है? जब हम देखते हैं थ्री डिमेंशनल एयर, मूवमेंट ऑफ एयर. दैट इज वाई एयर मासेस. इफ यू डोंट अंडरस्टैंड पोलर वोर्टेक्स, यू आर नॉट गोइंग टू अंडरस्टैंड ओजोन होल. हमने तो एक ही पॉइंट लिखा है ऑफ ओजोन होल. सो दिस इज वॉट इज एन एयर मास. वी से स्लोपिंग बाउंड्री. नाउ वॉट इज द कंडीशन फॉर द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ एयर मास? एक तो दे शुड कन्वर्ज एंड देयर शुड बी डिफरेंस ऑफ टेम्परेचर. Now, if you ask me where or at what places do the air masses converge? So we see air masses converge at equator. Fine. Jahan pe trade winds will come and they will converge, and we will call this as ITCZ. The other area where the air masses will converge is the polar, subpolar low pressure belt. Jahan pe easterlies and the westerlies are going to converge. But why, the question which is coming with regular frequency is, why do air masses do not form at ITCZ? We have solved this. Why? Because there is a convergence of same air masses. The next question they ask you, uska applied is, in spite of two different winds, air masses do not form at the subtropical high pressure belt. Because there is divergence. So for air masses, dono condition should be met. That is the cold air convergence and contrasting. So two different airs and there should be contrasting. Understood? Friends, everyone, ab depending upon which air is stronger, agar warm air is moving and entering the territory of cold air, you will call it as a warm front. If the cold air is coming and moving into the territory of warm air, then you will call this as a cold front. दोनों का आउटकम इज टोटली डिफरेंट. सो फर्स्ट वी विल डिफाइन व्हाट इज फ्रंट्स. फ्रंट इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक फ्रॉम आवर एग्जाम पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू. अ स्लोपिंग बाउंड्री between two contrasting air masses, between two contrasting air masses is known as front. Between two contrasting air masses is known as front. Boundary between two contrasting air masses is known as front. Next point, conditions for the formation of front. Conditions for the formation of front. First condition, kya hai? Difference between the properties of air masses. So, presence of contrasting air masses. 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 In the terms of temperature, pressure, and humidity. Temperature, pressure, and humidity. Dekho, temperature is the most important thing. So, underline temperature, because temperature is going to influence pressure and humidity. Second, convergence of air. Convergence of air. Convergence of air. So, hence, air masses, and hence air masses develop in the region of convergence of, develop in the regions of convergence of cold polar easterlies and warm westerlies, cold polar easterlies and warm westerlies. Develop in the regions of convergence of cold polar easterlies and warm westerlies. Fine. Types of fronts. There are four types of fronts. Warm front. Dusra, cold front. Third, occluded front, and fourth, stationary front. Stationary front. Can someone tell me what does the word occluded means? Occlusion means? So, occluded front, occlusion matlab something which is at a height, or occlusion matlab death. Upar kaun jata hai? So, occlusion matlab death. So, you will understand why this front is known as. So, you can take down. The process of formation of fronts, the process of formation of fronts is known as frontogenesis, is known as frontogenesis, while the process of death of a front is known as frontolysis. Lysis means death, genesis means birth. Frontogenesis and frontolysis. Death of a front is known as frontolysis. Frontogenesis. Frontogenesis causes cyclogenesis. Means kiska janm hua? Cyclone. Frontogenesis causes cyclogenesis, while frontolysis causes cyclolysis, that is the death of a cyclone. Kis cyclone ki hum baat kar rahe hai? Tropical ya subtropical? Temperate. temperate. We are not talking about the tropical cyclones. Getting it? Temperate cyclones. Occluded front. Causes. Death of fronts, matlab frontolysis. Which results into death of temperate cyclones. Now understand what is this front. We'll first do what is a warm front, what is a cold front. Occluded front is very easy. Stationary front, a theoretical concept, it does not occur in reality. Stationary front. This is just for theory building, stationary front. So this is cold air mass, easterlies. It is coming from east to west, easterlies poles. And it is moving right due to the Coriolis force in the northern hemisphere. This is moving to the left in the northern hemisphere, westerlies. These two are meeting. Now, after meeting, can I say this is the region of cold air, this is the region of warm air. But westerly apne direction mein andar jayegi in the regions of warm air. And easterlies will come southwards and it will enter the regions of warm air. Cold air will enter the region of warm air. Warm air is going to enter the region of cold air. So based on which air is dominant, we call it as a front. For example, if a warm air is dominant and enters the territory of cold air, it is known as warm front. So, kahan pe hai warm front? This is a warm front. Fine? Because the warm air is going into the territory of cold air. Imagine you are looking from the space. On the other hand, if the cold air is dominant and enters the territory of warm air, it is known as an cold front. So, this is the region of cold front. This is the region of warm front. Cold air comes into the territory of warm air. Now, what will happen in the warm front? What will happen on the cold front? So, first we'll understand what will happen in the warm front. So, what is warm front? Warm air enters the territory of cold air. Which is more powerful, warm air or cold air? Which is more powerful? Cold air. Powerful means, kabhi bhi, Dangal movie yaad rakhna. Whenever cold and warm air will meet, Dangal movie mein kya hai? Boxing or kushti? Kushti. So whenever the warm and cold air will meet, warm air will lift the cold air and throw it upwards. So who is more powerful? Cold air is more powerful. So there is cold air on the ground. Warm air comes with great speed. It is much lighter. It enters the territory of cold air. When it enters the territory of cold air, it cannot displace the cold air from the ground. This is not the diagram for exam. Therefore, the cold air starts rising upwards very gently. Warm air starts rising upwards very gently. Dheere dheere upar jayegi because it is a huge mass of an cold air. Ek to aayegi and it will come at great speed and it will be rising upwards comparatively with a gentle slope. Ye hai side view of a diagram. Geography mein when we make diagrams like this and they want to show you a side view, hamesha niche lines honge. That means cross section. It shows ki zameen kaati gayi hai. So as a result of this, the cold air, warm air comes and it rises without displacing the cold air. And this sloping boundary between the warm and the cold air is warm front. So, as the air is going upwards, warm air, understanding this, why it is known as warm front, everyone? As the gear is going upwards, is it cooling now? Yes, it is cooling. Vertically cool ho raha hai ya dheere se inclined manner mein? It is cooling in inclined manner. And as a result, because it is cooling in the inclined manner, it will form clouds. Condensation aise ho raha hai, condensation aise ho raha hai, and it will form the clouds. So, what are the clouds that are formed along the warm front? The clouds that are formed along the warm front are nimbo, stratus. Obviously, rainfall hoga, so you can directly write nimbo stratus, or stratus also you can write. Rainfall hone hi wala hai because the air is going upwards. Alto stratus, cirro stratus, and baad mein upar jaake very high clouds are cirrus clouds. And once nimbo stratus, you already you know that it is going to give precipitation. But how will be the precipitation? Gentle or heavy? Gentle. With lightning or thunder, or without lightning or thunder? Without lightning or thunder. For a longer duration or for a shorter duration? For a longer duration, because air dheere se upar ja rahi hai, it will occur for a longer duration. So that is warm front and the conditions associated with warm front. Agar India mein banta hai to gentle precipitation, agar US mein ya polar regions mein even Kashmir mein banta hai to gentle snowfall. But precipitation will always be there. It will be either a snowfall or it will be either a rainfall. UPSC had asked you a past year question, how to identify, dekho question hamesha inme se hi aayenge. How do you identify warm front from an approaching warm front? Approaching warm front matlab ek bar ye front ban gaya to piche se jo clouds hai, jo winds hai, they are going to push it. So how do you identify an approaching warm front? So that means you are standing here and aapko dekhna hai ki sky mein warm front aa raha hai ki nahi aapki taraf. So which clouds do you see in the sky? The presence of cirrus clouds in the sky say that the warm front is approaching. Getting it? Ye nahi samajh mein aaya. This is what is a warm front. Once it is developed, it will move towards the west. It will move towards the west under the influence of westerlies. Getting it? So how do you identify it is moving towards the west? Yeah, when it is moving towards the west, if you are standing here kahin dur Varanasi mein aur warm front has developed over Delhi, kaise pata lagega that warm front has developed and it is moving towards the east? How will you understand that it is coming towards India, Varanasi, by looking at cirrus clouds in the sky? Ye point aur clear ho jayega once we do the temperate cyclone. So this is what is a warm front. Very easy. You will understand why it goes to the east. Let me come to the temperate cyclone. Temperate cyclone, this is nothing but warm front, is nothing but temperate cyclone. If I mix too many things, you will get confused. So you get, first take down warm front diagram exam ke liye. I am drawing here. ये वाला एग्जाम को समझ में नहीं आएगा कि आपने क्या बनाया. सो ग्राउंड, कोल्ड एयर, वार्म फ्रंट, वार्म एयर, इट इज कमिंग फ्रॉम हियर and it is going upwards. So this is the diagram for exam. So you can take down. Can I continue? Warm front topic. So it develops in the regions. It develops in the region when the warm air is active, when the warm air is active and enters the territory of an cold air, and enters the territory of, when the warm air is active and enters the territory of cold air, enters the territory of cold air. Next point. The warm air being lighter, warm air being lighter, it rises upwards, it rises upwards along a gentle slope, along a gentle slope, underline the word gentle, along a gentle slope, along a gentle slope, such a gentle slope, or such gentle slope is known as warm front, is known as warm front. Weather conditions, as the air rises upwards gently, as the air rises upwards gently, as the air rises upwards gently, it cools slowly, it cools slowly, forming stratus clouds, forming stratus clouds. ये सब मत लिखना, निम्बो अल्टो, ये अंडरस्टूड है. दैट विल बी ऑन द हाइट. क्यों? क्योंकि एयर धीरे से ऊपर जा रही है. सो जो कूलिंग हो रहा है, इट इज ऑकरिंग इन अ शीट लाइक मैनर. सो वेन एवर इट इज ऑकरिंग इन अ शीट लाइक मैनर, इट इज स्ट्रेटस क्लाउड्स, फॉर्मिंग स्ट्रेटस क्लाउड्स, विच गिव्स जेंटल टू मॉडरेट प्रेसिपिटेशन, gentle to moderate precipitation, gentle to moderate precipitation, occurring for longer duration, gentle to moderate precipitation for longer duration. That's it. Very easy to understand. Upwards. Now you should also know that ye jo area maine banaya hai, it can be Punjab and this can be UP ka end. It is a very big phenomena, dheere se upar ja rahi hai, and it is giving an region precipitation for longer duration. Now understand what is an cold front. Can I rub this diagram? So what will be the cold front? We have a diagram for reference of a warm front up. The warm air, the cold air is active and it enters the territory of which air? Warm air. Warm air ka height hum zyada manayenge in our reference diagram because it is lighter. The cold air is coming downwards. It is coming downwards and it is flowing with very, very less speed. Why it is flowing with less speed? Because friction is more. So when it comes and in the contact with the warm air, which air will go up? Warm air. But how does that warm air goes up? The warm air goes, that is the cold air will come and vertically throw the warm air upwards. Hum kya likh rahe? Vertically throws, not lifts. Gently, it vertically throws. So reality mein, I say, as soon as they touch, the warm air will become unstable and it will rise upwards, resulting into a formation of a very steep slope. Jahan se this air is rising upwards, understand gentle, understand steep slope, and this is what is known as an cold front. Up, whenever there is a steep slope, which cloud will come? Cumulonimbus. And whenever there is a cumulonimbus cloud, aage, you know, it is associated with heavy rainfall, lightning, thunder, but of a shorter duration. क्यों? क्योंकि इट विल कम एंड लिफ्ट द वार्म एयर अपवर्ड्स वर्टिकली. नाउ जितना ज्यादा टेम्परेचर डिफरेंस बिटवीन दिस टू एयर मासेस, कोल्ड एंड वार्म एयर मासेस, उतना वर्टिकली द वार्म एयर विल बी लिफ्टेड. एंड इसीलिए आप देखते हो इन यूएसए विच डज नॉट हैव ईस्ट वेस्ट माउंटेन्स लाइक हिमालयस और लाइक एल्प्स, सो द पोलर एयर कैन कम टू द इंटीरियर पार्ट्स ऑफ यूएसए. अंडरस्टैंडिंग दिस? इफ दिस इज आवर यूएसए, आवर यूएसए मीन्स हमारा डायग्राम का यूएसए, देर इज नो माउंटेन विच विल स्टॉप द पोलर एयर. द पोलर एयर कम्स इन द सदर्न पार्ट्स ऑफ यूएसए विच इज वार्मर, and as a result when the cold and warm air will mix, USA may very dangerous atmospheric disturbances known as tornadoes are very very common. So tornado is an example of an cold front. What is tornado? Have you seen tornado? Movies mein obviously, वैसे तो कोई नहीं देख सकता. तो कौन सी movie है tornado के लिए? Twister. That is when the cold and the warm air will mix, the warm air is vertically thrown upwards and it results into the formation of tornado. Bahut hi strong air movement which goes upwards. Tornado is the most dangerous of all atmospheric disturbance. Why? Because tropical cyclones, wind speed 300 kilometers per hour, 120 kilometers per hour. Tornado minimum wind speed 700 kilometers per hour. This is such a small low pressure center, but there is so much greater difference between this low pressure warm air and the high pressure ki ghar ke chhat automatically ud jate, bottles ke cork automatically khul jate, and sometimes bodies bhi burst ho jati hai because it you are in the so much low pressure zone. That is body ka pressure badh jata hai and body will tear apart, it will throw apart. That is what is tornado. Thankfully, tornado do not develop in India because tornadoes are so dangerous, and best thing about the tornado is tornado kabhi akela nahi aayega, they always occur in groups. Imagine what would have happened in India if it developed in the Great Plains which are already densely populated, but India mein nahi ho sakta because Himalayas protect us. Tornadoes are very common in USA because there is no mountain barrier like Himalayas. Because this is cold front. Cold front, cold air is coming into the territory of warm air. So warm air is always in the southern side. Warm air is USA. Warm air kahan pe hai? Southern side. Upar to cold air hai. So cold front cannot. Yahan pe this is the region of warm front. This is the region of cold fronts. So extensive cold fronts will result into tornadoes, extensive. And normal cold front India mein bhi aata hai. So some days back you had a rainfall at night. How was the rainfall? Very heavy or drizzle? That is warm front precipitation. Kuch and February mein jo rainfall hoga just before, that is just Baisakhi we will celebrate ki garmi aa gayi hai. एंड उसके बाद एंड ऑफ फेब्रुआरी जैन एंड अर्ली फेब एक ऐसा कोल्ड वेव आएगा इंडिया में, यू आर गोइंग टू ब्लेम, अरे गर्मी हमें लगा, मैंने स्वेटर पैक कर दिया था, फिर से स्वेटर निकालना पड़ेगा. दैट इज बिकॉज दैट इज द टाइम व्हेन द कोल्ड फ्रंट्स अराइव इन इंडिया. कोल्ड फ्रंट या वार्म फ्रंट इज बोथ, दोनों को हम नाम दे देते हैं वेस्टर्न डिस्टर्बेंसेस बिकॉज दे आर नथिंग बट टेम्परेट साइक्लोन इज मेड अप ऑफ वन पार्ट इज वार्म फ्रंट, वन पार्ट इज कोल्ड फ्रंट. पिछले साल कोल्ड फ्रंट प्रेसिपिटेशन ऑकर्ड ऑन 26 जनवरी. वेन एवर देर इज फ्रंट, रेनफॉल भी होगा, बट कैन यू सी उसके साथ साथ देर विल बी फॉर्मेशन ऑफ फॉग्स बाय टेम्परेचर इन्वर्शन. सो इनिशियली देर विल बी टेम्परेचर इन्वर्शन एंड देन द टेम्परेचर इन्वर्शन विल बी रिमूव्ड. सो अगर कुछ दिनों में दैट डे वी लर्न अबाउट वेस्टर्न डिस्टर्बेंसेस, शाम को हो गया. सो अगर आज हैवी रेनफॉल आता है अलॉन्ग विथ लाइटनिंग एंड थंडर, यू शुड नो इट इज कोल्ड फ्रंट. अगर लाइट रेनफॉल आता है देन इट इज वार्म फ्रंट. इन दोनों को हम कहते हैं टेम्परेट साइक्लोन्स. नहीं, विल डू दैट वाइल. क्यों नहीं है वार्म एयर? it is all relative. Warm does not mean it is extremely warmer. Thunderstorm मतलब mechanism same है. Thunderstorm हमारे यहाँ पे होता है, we call it as आंधी etc. Mechanism दोनों का same है, but tornado is very dangerous, very low pressure area. नहीं नहीं नहीं, they will occur either in the subtropical regions or in the polar regions. Understanding the difference. So what you will be writing, what is the keyword? Warm front, gentle, a steep, air vertically rises upwards, cumulonimbus cloud, stratus clouds. Aage ka fir aapko pata hai stratus mein kya hai, cumulonimbus mein kya hai. Getting this? If air कभी भी सीधी ऊपर नहीं जाएगी, we cannot show it. Air will always go upwards in a spiraling manner. Fine? Can I continue? Cold front. Cold front occurs when cold air is active and this cold air enters the subtropical regions or the regions of warm air. The subtropical regions or the regions of warm air. As the cold air is denser, it travels with slow speeds. And when it comes in the contact with warm air, the cold air vertically throws the warm air. Forming a steep slope, known as cold front. Weather conditions. Cold front causes cumulonimbus cloud, which gives heavy precipitation, along with lightning and thunder. but over a short, smaller area, but over a smaller area, over a smaller area. इसका एरिया देखो, ये पूरा बारिश होने वाली है, इसका एरिया देखो, only smaller area. And of a shorter duration, and of shorter duration. Of shorter duration. Next point. In North America as a continent, in North America, as there is an absence of East-West Mountain Barrier. Cold Polar Easterlies. Enter. The Great Plains, USA, which are known as prairies, great plains, forming tornadoes or twister. ट्विस्टर नाम की मूवी भी है, फॉर्मिंग टॉर्नेडोज और ट्विस्टर. फाइन. थंडरस्टॉर्म ही होता है, हमने लिखा है दे आर नोन एज थंडर क्लाउड. लाइटनिंग एंड थंडर मतलब क्या, थंडरस्टॉर्म तो लिखा है ना. थंडरस्टॉर्म इज अ डिफरेंट फिनोमिना, डोंट मिक्स दिस टू. थंडरस्टॉर्म इज अ डिफरेंट फिनोमिना, वो हम कल करेंगे. थंडरस्टॉर्म्स बट वार्म फ्रंट ऊपर है, वो उसकी कम स्पीड होती है. If a tornado is formed in the water bodies, water is vertically thrown upwards, forming water spout. Have you seen some photos जिसमें समंदर से पानी ऐसे ऊपर जा रहा है? That is a cold front. I'll show you the photos tomorrow. We'll first complete all these things. I'll show you the photos tomorrow then. Water spout, tornadoes, etc. What? Yes, the same. Water spout. Maharashtra में नहीं हो सकता. Not tornado. ये phenomena हो जाएगा, but not tornado. Occluded front. Now you tell me, what is happening in the region of cold air, cold front? कौन सी air ऊपर जा रही है? Warm air. नीचे कौन सी बचेगी? Once a cold front is completed. Cold air. What is happening in the warm front? कौन सी air is going upwards? Warm air. So which air will remain on the ground? Cold air. So that is when we say occluded front. So in the end क्या होगा? Whether it is warm front or cold front, cold air will come down and the warm air will be thrown upwards. So when this entire process happens, when the cold air totally displaces the warm air from the ground, means ground पे there is no warm air, whether in the cold front, whether in the warm front. You call that front as an occluded front. मतलब जमीन पे कौन सी एयर है? कोल्ड. ऊपर कौन सी एयर है? warm. So what is front? Cold and warm air are in the sloping boundary. Once an occluded front is formed, cold air is on the ground, warm air is above. So ye front rahega, ya it is a death of a front. Death, because it is not a sloping boundary. Ye to temperature inversion hai. So therefore we say occluded front is associated with frontolysis and also death of a cyclone. So what do you mean by occluded front? When the cold air completely displaces the warm air from the ground. So air kaun si upar feki ja rahi hai?
Warm.
Therefore occlusion, rising up. Getting it? Occluded front, koi weather phenomena hoga? No. So you can take down occluded front. Occluded front occurs when cold air completely displaces the warm air from the ground. Cold air completely displaces the warm air from the ground. Completely displaces the warm air from the ground. Completely displaces warm air from the ground. Or in other words, main NCERT ki line de raha hu. In other words, when the cold front, completely overtakes the warm front. Cold front completely overtakes the warm front. You'll understand what does this line means when doing the cyclones. So we are going to start now. So the diagram for the occluded front is this. First you draw the diagram, I'll explain you the diagram. Draw these diagrams in the exam. Have you finished this? Kya meaning hai is diagram ka? Whether area is a region of warm front, matlab low pressure, isliye height kam ho rahi hai triangle ki, or the region of cold front, matlab high pressure. Dono jage ground pe there will be cold air and warm air will be thrown upwards. So isliye hum ye वार्म फ्रंट बना रहे, ये कोल्ड फ्रंट बना रहे, बता रहे कि सब सारे फ्रंट्स विंड्स कंबाइन हो गए, फ्रंट खत्म हो गया, एक जगह दो फ्रंट नहीं हो सकते. सो ऑन द ग्राउंड देर इज कोल्ड एयर, ऊपर देर इज अ वार्म एयर. सो दिस इज व्हाट इज ऑक्लूडेड फ्रंट. क्या है ये डायग्राम? इंस्टेड ऑफ मेकिंग अ हॉरिजॉन्टल ग्राउंड, आप ग्राउंड इसमें दिखाते हो एज ट्राइंगल. वाई एज ट्राइंगल? इट इज एन ज्योग्राफिकल proper scientific way of representation, jahan pe triangle represents barometric pressure, high pressure, low pressure. Ye sab likhna nahi hai exam mein. This is a way of showing diagrams. And ground pe it is cold air, so jis samay jahan pe low pressure hai warm front, jahan pe high pressure hai cold front. So and the warm air has gone upwards. Understanding this? In simple words, ye diagram aise rahega. If you want to understand, ground pe there will be only cold air and upar there will be warm air. ये वार्म एयर यहां से धीरे से ऊपर जाएगी वार्म फ्रंट से, एंड जहां जहां कोल्ड फ्रंट है वो वर्टिकली ऊपर जाएगी. देयरफॉर ऑक्लूडेड. अंडरस्टूड द डायग्राम? लास्ट लाइन जो एनसीईआरटी की मैंने डिक्टेट की है, when the cold front overtakes the warm front, you will understand now when we are doing the temperate cyclone. Fine with this? Stationary front. Diagram समझ में नहीं आया? Diagram कुछ नहीं, बहुत simple है. Cold front को लिया, warm front को लिया, दोनों को combine किया, दिखाया कि whatever the front is, warm air is going upwards, on the ground there will be cold air. ग्राउंड की रिप्रेजेंटेशन ऐसी है बिकॉज दैट इज द वे ऑफ शोइंग प्रेशर. हाई प्रेशर, लो प्रेशर. तो लो प्रेशर रीजन्स में है, हाई प्रेशर रीजन है. सो डोंट गो बाय डायग्राम कि ये ऐसा क्यों है, ये ऐसा है. सो रिमेंबर दिस इज द वे ऑफ ड्रॉइंग अ डायग्राम. और एनीवेज जीएस में अगर आपने नॉर्मल भी बनाया तो कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं होगा, ऐसे भी बना सकते हो, बट दिस इज द प्रॉपर वे ऑफ रिप्रेजेंटिंग अ डायग्राम. मतलब so you take down stationary front. A stationary front is formed, stationary front is formed when the two air masses instead of converging, flow parallel to each other. So you can draw the diagram for this. Stationary front kya hai in reality? It cannot be there. This is just a step one for the formation of cyclone. Matlab inka kehna hai, agar aap upar se dekh rahe ho, to cold air hai, warm air hai, they are not converging. They apni jagah ruke hai wo. Kisi whistle ke liye, chalo abhi cyclone banana shuru karo. So that is stationary front. जो ऑब्वियसली रियल लाइफ में होगा नहीं. देन व्हाई वी स्टडी दिस? बिकॉज अभी जब हम करेंगे टेम्परेट साइक्लोन, हम लिखेंगे स्टेप वन फॉर्मेशन ऑफ स्टेशनरी फ्रंट, स्टेप टू कन्वर्जन शुरू हो जाएगा, फिर स्टेप थ्री, स्टेप फोर. सो दिस इज जस्ट फॉर स्टेप वन. ये थियरी यू हैव टू स्टार्ट फ्रॉम स्क्रैच. व्हाई आर द फ्रंट्स इंपॉर्टेंट? Fronts are important because they help in the formation of temperate cyclones. Fronts are important because they help in the formation of temperate cyclones. So, cyclones. What are cyclones? Any idea what is a cyclone? Tell me the cyclone. क्या हो रहा है आंध्र प्रदेश में? अभी बारिश हो रही है. सो बारिश जब होगी ड्यू टू हाई प्रेशर और लो प्रेशर? लो प्रेशर. लो प्रेशर सेंटर. सो कैन आई से साइक्लोन इज अ लो प्रेशर सेंटर? क्या है साइक्लोन कि समवेयर देर इज अ लो प्रेशर सेंटर एंड उसके ऊपर द प्रेशर कीप्स ऑन इंक्रीजिंग इन अ सर्कुलर मैनर. वैसे ये आइडियल डायग्राम फॉर साइक्लोन इज द डायग्राम ऑफ ट्रॉपिकल साइक्लोन. फॉर एग्जाम्पल वी शो द प्रेशर विद द हेल्प ऑफ आइसोबार. सो ये एक आइसोबार है, ये एक आइसोबार है, दैट इज दिस एंटायर रीजन बिटवीन दिस टू आइसोबार इज हैविंग द सेम प्रेशर. द एरिया बिटवीन दिस टू आइसोबार इज हैविंग द सेम प्रेशर एंड देन अंदर देर विल बी वन प्रेशर. फॉर एग्जाम्पल इट कैन बी 900 मिलीबार्स, इट कैन बी 910 मिलीबार्स, 920 मिलीबार्स, 930 मिलीबार्स. दैट इज साइक्लोन इज अ लो प्रेशर सेंटर विथ इंक्रीजिंग प्रेशर आउटवर्ड्स. Because the pressure increases outwards, what is the law of wind? Wind always flows from high pressure to low pressure. So wind starts flowing from the outside high pressure to the central low pressure, upar se dikh raha hai ye, in such a way that they become anti-clockwise in northern hemisphere. They become anti-clockwise in the northern hemisphere. ऐसे घूम के हुए जाएगा in an anti-clockwise manner in the northern hemisphere. फिर यहाँ पे जाके the air will rise upwards, or they flow in a clockwise manner in the southern hemisphere. Clockwise manner in the southern hemisphere. And depending upon the difference between the pressure, high pressure and low pressure, that will determine the speed of the wind. If this low pressure and outside high pressure is too great, like tropical cyclone, the wind speed is greater. Agar wo bahut kam hai, like temperate cyclone, the wind speed will be lesser. But this is an idea of an pressure in cyclone in the southern hemisphere. And this is a diagram for the cyclone in the northern hemisphere. So, anti-clockwise, ghadi ke opposite direction mein in northern hemisphere, clockwise in the southern hemisphere. क्यों? Because of Coriolis effect. इतना ही याद रखना GS के लिए. वैसे Coriolis effect है नहीं इसका only reason. फिर हमें एक theory करनी पड़ेगी, जिसको interest है वो notes ले लेना optional के. फालतू में पढ़ोगे कभी पूछेंगे नहीं UPSC GS में. optional में अभी तक नहीं पूछा है, क्योंकि फिर आपको तीन टाइप के विंड्स पता करनी पड़ेगी, सेंट्रीफ्यूगल, सेंट्रीपिटल, प्रेशर ग्रेडियंट, फ्रिक्शनल एंड कोरियोलिस. उन सब का इक्वेशन विल फाइनली डिटरमाइन द साइक्लोन्स का डायरेक्शन. कोई जरूरत नहीं जीएस के लिए याद रखना ड्यू टू कोरियोलिस फोर्स. पर घर पे जाके ये मत करना कोरियोलिस फोर्स से तो राइट में जाना चाहिए नॉर्दर्न हेमिस्फीयर में, पर वो लेफ्ट में जा रहा है. एंड यहां पे लेफ्ट में जाना चाहिए तो ये तो राइट में जा रहा है. सो कोरियोलिस फोर्स इज नॉट द रीजन. रीजन इज द बैलेंस बिटवीन द कोरियोलिस फोर्स एंड द प्रेशर ग्रेडियंट फोर्स, वेयर प्रेशर ग्रेडियंट फोर्स बिकम सो बिगर कि वो निगेट करता है इफेक्ट ऑफ एन कोरियोलिस फोर्स. नहीं समझ में आएगा सो फॉरगेट इट. जीएस के लिए एंटी क्लॉकवाइज एंड एंटी क्लॉकवाइज. सो कैन आई डिक्टेट साइक्लोन्स? So cyclones are low pressure centers. Cyclones are low pressure centers surrounded by low pressure centers surrounded by closed isobars ISOBARS closed isobars with increasing pressure outwards with increasing pressure outwards. With increasing pressure outwards. And wind flows from, and the wind flows from outside high pressure to the central low pressure. Outside high pressure to the central low pressure. In such a way, that winds deflect anti-clockwise in the northern hemisphere. Winds deflect anti-clockwise in the northern hemisphere. And clockwise in the southern hemisphere. And clockwise in the southern hemisphere. Clockwise in the southern hemisphere. Deflection zaruri hai cyclones mein?
Yes.
So deflection is caused by which force? Coriolis force. So we identify a region where the tropical cyclones will not originate on the equator. Kyun? Kyunki Coriolis force is absent or zero. Next, there are two kinds of cyclones. There are two types of cyclones. Two types of cyclones. Tropical cyclones. Tropical cyclones. Which originate between 10 degree north to 30 degree north and 10 degree south to 30 degree south. It originate between 10 degree north to 30 degree north and 10 degree south to 30 degree south. Don't write in the exam 10 to 30 degrees north and south. तो इक्वेटर भी आ जाएगा उसमें एंड एक्स्ट्रा ट्रॉपिकल साइक्लोन्स और टेम्परेट साइक्लोन्स. Which originate between 35 degree north to 65 degree north and 35 to 65 degree south. 35 to 65 degree south. किसने बोला कोरियोलिस फोर्स मैटर नहीं कर रहा? हाफ नॉलेज इज ऑलवेज डेंजरस. किसने बोला कि वी आर नॉट कंसिडरिंग द डिफ्लेक्शन? वही तो मैं इतना समझाया कि डोंट वरी अबाउट द डिफ्लेक्शन, इट इज आउट ऑफ योर स्कोप ऑफ जनरल स्टडीज. लेकिन नहीं, वो आएगा ही नहीं कभी. Andrew Haywood कभी polity में नहीं आएगा. There is always a, so this is a very core. Jet streams भी हम बहुत superficially करते हैं. General studies, syllabus is still 12th. Optional syllabus is still, कोई भी optional, till post graduation, honors level. Difference है 12th and honors level. So what are this? These are the areas of tropical cyclone. I can teach you that, but it will take 1.5 hours. Aur ko iska koi fayda nahi hoga. If you want to read, you can read from the optional ka notes. and the blue color is the region of temperate cyclones. Region of temperate cyclones. नो नीड ऑफ ड्रॉइंग दिस एरो, मैं आपको सिर्फ एक्स्ट्रा चीज बता रहा हूँ जो हम कल करेंगे. ये जो जितने भी एटमॉस्फेरिक डिस्टर्बेंस है, हरिकेन, टाइफून्स और विली विलीज और साइक्लॉन्स, दैट मीन्स ट्रॉपिकल साइक्लॉन्स एंड वेस्टर्न डिस्टर्बेंसेस मीन्स टेम्परेट साइक्लॉन्स. दिस इज देयर नॉर्मल एरिया ऑफ ओरिजिन. But up sun is in the southern hemisphere. So, ये blue area will shift to the south. इतना भी south नहीं कि पूरे India को cover कर लेगा, but it will shift slightly to the south, which will cover North India. And therefore, temperate cyclones will come to North India and give rainfall, which we'll call them as western disturbances. Can I continue? So what are the names of tropical cyclones? USMA, hurricanes. Cyclone Gaja, cyclone Fetai, Indian Ocean mein. South China Sea mein and Japan mein typhoons. सी थोड़ा ज्यादा नॉर्थ में है वो. ऑस्ट्रेलिया में विली विलीज, दे ऑल आर इन द ट्रेड विंड बेल्ट एंड टेम्परेट साइक्लॉन्स आर इन द वेस्टर्ली बेल्ट. बिकॉज दे आर इन द ट्रेड विंड बेल्ट, उनका डायरेक्शन इज फ्रॉम ईस्ट टू वेस्ट. सो इसलिए इट अफेक्ट्स द ईस्टर्न कोस्ट ऑफ इंडिया ईस्ट टू वेस्ट, बट इट डज नॉट अफेक्ट द western coast of India. We'll do this tomorrow. We'll first do with the extra tropical cyclones. So take down extra tropical cyclones. They are also known as wave cyclones. Wave cyclones or temperate cyclones or temperate depressions or temperate depressions. Wave cyclones or temperate cyclones or temperate depressions. Next, they originate due to convergence of two contrasting air masses. Originate due to the convergence of two contrasting air masses. They originate due to the convergence of two contrasting air masses. That is, in other words, temperate cyclones are associated with formation of fronts. temperate cyclones are associated with the formation of fronts. Associated with the formation of fronts. Next, after their origin, the temperate cyclones move from west to east. Kyun? Kaunse winds? Under the influence of westerly winds. Now, don't draw anything. Understand the formation. Kya hai? And then you will have time to draw. Pehle, they are associated with the formation of fronts. What do you mean by fronts? Convergence of two contrasting air masses. Fine. So, ye cold air is coming into the area of warm air is going into the area of cold air. So, ye warm front and this is cold front. What do you understand by cyclone? Low pressure, center. Baki ki jage, high pressure. Matlab, aapko is diagram mein ye tab dekhna hai, jab beech mein warm air trap ho jati hai. And side mein sari cold air hai. You are looking at this from top. Ground pe kya ho raha hai. So, in the second stage, what is happening here? The warm air is going into the territory of cold air and it is getting lifted upwards. What is happening here? Cold air is coming into the territory of warm air and it is throwing the warm air vertically upwards. Cold front, warm front. Now, over the period of time, understand, the fronts will be converted into somewhat like this. Kya hai ye? Why it is projecting outwards? It is projecting outwards because the warm air is going into the territory of cold air. It is pushing itself into the territory of cold air. And yahan pe jaake it is going upwards. Matlab, cold air will not be displaced from here. So, this is the region of cold air. Cold air is coming here in the territory of warm air. But law of wind is high pressure to low pressure. So, sabse zyada warm air is concentrated in this narrow region. So, garmi sabse zyada is here. And therefore, the cold air will come towards the region of warm air. Can you see? Due to pressure gradient, deflection ho raha hai wind ka. And Coriolis force is supporting this deflection. A deflection nahi hota had this situation been at the equator. Because deflection ke liye there has to be Coriolis force. Cold front and warm front. Will the cold air from here be displaced? Is the warm air itna powerful ki ye push karega cold air ko? No. So, yahan pe bhi cold air hai. Kyunki warm air is gently rising upwards. Yahan pe bhi cold air hoga. Because it is throwing the warm air upwards. So, ye diagram aise bante jayega. That is, isko ye diagram aise dikhata hai ki this is the entire area belongs to the cold air. Ab dheere se what is going to happen in the next step? Yahan se the cold air is going upwards. Yahan se the warm air is being thrown upwards. Warm air is going upwards. Warm air is being thrown upwards. So, kiska area decrease hoga over the period of time? Ye ground situation hai. Warm air ka area will decrease. Kiska area advance ho jayega over the period of time? Cold air ka area is going to advance. Understanding everyone? This is happening at the ground. Warm air upar ja rahi hai. Warm air is being thrown upwards. So, the area of warm air which is wider here, it is decreasing. And the cold air ka area will advance. So, in the third situation, we can say cold air ka area will advance while the warm air ka area will decrease. So, this is how the warm air ka area has decreased and this is how the cold air ka area has advanced. So can I say the cold air is trapping the warm air from all the sides, because warm air is not able to displace the cold air. What is going to happen more? Area or decrease ho jayega. This is cold front, this is warm front. Can you see in our third stage, cold warm air is being trapped in the center, and dheere se how it is being trapped in the center, and dheere se the cold air is surrounding. So this is the stage of cyclogenesis, frontogenesis results into cyclogenesis. Getting everyone? Dheere, the area of cold air will be still reduced, warm air will be still reduced, and there will be maturity of a cyclone. So ye hai area of a cold warm air, it is reducing, and the cold air is surrounding the warm air from all the sides. Center mein which air is there? Warm air. So what is a cyclone? Low pressure center, that is a warm air on the center, while it is being surrounded on all the sides. So this is how the cyclone has formed and matured. Cold front, warm front. Everyone understanding this diagram? Over the period of time, can I say warm front udhar hi rahega? Because it cannot push, it does not have the power to push the cold air. Wo khud se upar ja raha hai. But yahan se the cold air is having the power to push the warm air. So can I say in the next diagram, cold front thoda aur advance hoga? Aur advance hoga? Aur advance hoga? So can I say maybe in the fifth, there will be narrowing down of the region jahan pe warm air hai, and we will call this as warm sector. So there will be narrowing down of warm sector, warm air will be trapped in a very, very small area. So this is the warm air, and it is being surrounded by cold air from all the sides. Again, this is how the cyclone has matured. Ab koi bhi iske beech mein trap hua, to wo depending upon whether that person is at the cold front or warm front, usko rainfall, the kind of a rainfall he is going to experience. Can I say the cold front will further advance? Ye aur aage advance hoga. Ultimately, there will be cold air on the ground and warm air will be totally upwards. So what do you call that front as? Occluded front. Kyunki the cold front will advance, and there will be no warm air. Warm air totally upar chali jayegi. Occluded front humne likha hai, isliye results into death of fronts as well as the death of cyclones. Occlusion, and इसीलिए NCERT में दिया है, मैंने simple language में दिया, when the cold air completely displaces the warm air. Now this 11th standard NCERT is known for tough language, उसने दिया when the cold front completely displaces the warm front, overtakes the warm front. So in the end there will be no warm air, there will be only cold air on the ground. बाकी यहाँ पे जो वेस्टर्लीज आ रही है वो आती रहेगी, जो ईस्टर्लीज पहले आ रही है, दैट इज आगे जाके और फिर से एक नया साइक्लोन बनेगा. सो दिस इज व्हाट इज एन ऑक्लूडेड फ्रंट, एंड दिस फिनोमिना इज नोन एज एन टेम्परेट साइक्लोन. गेटिंग इट? This phenomena is known as a temperate cyclone. This can be a diagram of cyclone. This can be a diagram of cyclone. This can be also a diagram of cyclone. Warm air is trapped in between. So these are the stages in the formation of temperate cyclone. Fine? Is diagram ko koi meaning nahi hai. Ye ab kaise bhi lines dikha do, the only thing, make sure that you have to show cold air on the ground. करना है तो करो. यू वॉन्ट टू ड्रॉ दिस? या रिवर्स्ड सदर्न हेमिस्फीयर डायरेक्शन विल बी रिवर्स्ड. southern hemisphere mein cold air will be coming from ground and therefore we say clockwise. Aise jayegi cold air clockwise, this is anti clockwise. This diagram का scope बहुत कम है for exam, but this will be for your understanding only. Westerly winds नीचे से आया था, there is a continuous westerly wind blowing, easterly is going on. ज़्यादा depends upon the temperature difference, heating, kitna temperature difference hai between cold and warm air mass. So you tell me, cold front and warm front can occur anywhere, whether it is land, whether it is sea, whether it is ocean. कहीं पे भी तो converge हो सकती है warm and cold air. इसलिए जब हम कल difference करेंगे between temperate cyclones and tropical cyclone, one of the major differences, tropical cyclones only on water body, क्योंकि it requires latent heat that comes from water, while the temperate cyclones can occur both on land and sea. ट्रॉपिकल साइक्लॉन हीटिंग से है, इसलिए समर्स टेम्परेट साइक्लॉन्स थ्रू आउट द ईयर, बस उनको क्या जरूरत है मिक्सिंग अप ऑफ वार्म एंड कोल्ड एयर. ऑब्वियसली स्ट्रॉन्गर ड्यूरिंग द विंटर सीजन बिकॉज दैट ब्लू एयर कोल्ड एयर विल बी वेरी वेरी कोल्ड ड्यूरिंग द विंटर सीजन. कंटिन्यूअस प्रोसेस साल भर आते रहेंगे, ओनली एरियाज विल कीप ऑन शिफ्टिंग. और यहाँ पे कौन सी जेट स्ट्रीम है ऊपर, वेस्टर्ली या ईस्टर्ली? वेस्टर्ली. सो वंस दे आर फॉर्म्ड दे विल मूव फ्रॉम वेस्ट टू ईस्ट. अभी के डायग्राम में हमने देखा टेम्परेट ट्रॉपिकल साइक्लॉन्स फ्रॉम ईस्ट टू वेस्ट. सो यू कैन टेक डाउन द temperate cyclones originate with frontogenesis. And as fronts can occur, on both land and sea, temperate cyclones can originate on both land and sea. कहीं पे भी हो सकता है convergence, both land and sea. ट्रॉपिकल साइक्लॉन्स जस्ट रिमेंबर अभी इन माइंड डिफरेंस ओनली ऑन सी, दिस आर ऑन बोथ लैंड एंड सी. सेकेंड पॉइंट द टेम्परेट साइक्लॉन्स कैन ओरिजिनेट इन एनी सीजन बिकॉज दे रिक्वायर कन्वर्जेंस ऑफ कॉन्ट्रास्टिंग एयर मासेस. Because they require convergence of contrasting air masses. but they become stronger during winters. Contrasting air masses, but they become stronger during the winters. Next point.
After their origin,
the temperate cyclones move from west to east under the influence of westerly wind circulation. मतलब इसमें दोनों याद रखना, वेस्टर्ली विंड सर्कुलेशन, अपर एयर भी एंड ग्राउंड वेस्टर्लीज भी. वेस्टर्ली विंड्स ऑन द ग्राउंड एज वेल एज सब ट्रॉपिकल वेस्टर्ली या पोलर वेस्टर्ली जेट स्ट्रीम. नेक्स्ट, अनलाइक द ट्रॉपिकल साइक्लोन्स the temperate cyclones do not have closed isobars. isobar, ये है आइडियल डायग्राम ऑफ ट्रॉपिकल साइक्लोन. लो प्रेशर, बाहर प्रेशर बढ़ते जाएगा. यहाँ पे नहीं है ऐसा. ऑब्वियसली ये थोड़ा ज़्यादा गर्म होगा, देन ये कम गर्म, ये ज़्यादा कोल्ड. जैसे पोल्स की तरफ जाओगे ज़्यादा कोल्ड, बट यहाँ पे आइसोबार्स आर नॉट क्लोज्ड, दे आर ओपन. सो वी डू नॉट से दे आर हैविंग अ क्लोज्ड आइसोबार्स. देयरफॉर दे आर जनरली रेफर्ड एज V's. They are generally referred as V. Only the word V. Next point. In the tropical cyclone, there are different temperatures in different parts. Suppose this temperate cyclone, right? Not tropical. In the temperate cyclones, there are different temperatures in the different parts. For example, if this is our temperate cyclone, this is in northern hemisphere, so this will be cold, this will be warm. ये भी डिफरेंस है बिटवीन टेम्परेट एंड ट्रॉपिकल साइक्लोन. ट्रॉपिकल साइक्लोन विल बी वेरी वेरी हॉट ओनली. लास्ट पॉइंट, एज द प्रेशर डिफरेंस, और व्हाट इज द अदर वर्ड फॉर द प्रेशर डिफरेंस, प्रेशर ग्रेडियंट. प्रेशर ग्रेडियंट और प्रेशर डिफरेंस इज नॉट ग्रेटर. Winds flow with low velocity. ब्रैकेट में लिखना 35 km/h. Flow with low velocity. ये ट्रॉपिकल साइक्लोन्स में 128 km/h अगर उसने क्रॉस किया विंड ने, तो ही उसको साइक्लोन कहा जाता है. यहाँ पे पूरी एंटायरली डेवलप्ड साइक्लोन इज 35 km/h. सो जब भी यहाँ बारिश होगी, उसे विंड दिखेगी नहीं, हमें लगेगी नहीं कि विंड इज ब्लोइंग. फ्लो विथ लो वेलोसिटी. नेक्स्ट सब हेडिंग structure of tropical cyclone, temperate cyclones. Now this is the structure of a temperate cyclone, fine. This is from top, right? अब you understand, I'm just opening up this temperate cyclone कि हमें ground पे कैसे दिखेगा. Once it originates, वो कौन से direction में move करेगा? From west to east. So the structure of temperate cyclone will be very different from the tropical cyclone. So I am taking this as our ground. ये तो ऊपर से दिख रहा है हमें कि ये ऐसे दिख रहा है, but actually the tropic temperate cyclone will be somewhat like this. What are this? Clouds. This is how the temperate cyclone will look like. Cold air part, so cold air. फिर कौन सा front है? वार्म फ्रंट, जेंटल, फिर वार्म एयर का सेक्टर, फिर कोल्ड फ्रंट एंड देन कोल्ड एयर का सेक्टर. अंडरस्टैंडिंग दिस डायग्राम, वी आर जस्ट टेकिंग अ क्रॉस सेक्शनल व्यू ऑफ दिस कि कैसे दिखेगा टेम्परेट साइक्लोन. हैव यू अंडरस्टूड दिस डायग्राम? दिस इज फ्रॉम टॉप, इसको कट करो, गो टू दिस साइड, मतलब ये तो वर्टिकल है. If you look it from horizontally, कैसे दिखेगा? This is a cold air, so that is a cold air. उसके बाद what is there? Warm front, so that is a warm front. उसके बाद what is there? Warm air sector. उसके बाद cold front, what happens along the cold front? Tornadoes or cumulonimbus cloud, दोनों है, depending upon where it is formed. And उसके बाद there is a cold air का sector, so cold air का sector. अब ये पूरा जो फिनोमिना है, एंटायर दिस फिनोमिना, दिस इज टेम्परेट साइक्लोन, अनलाइक ट्रॉपिकल साइक्लोन. ट्रॉपिकल साइक्लोन कुछ अलग ही है. सो दिस एंटायर फिनोमिना इज अ टेम्परेट साइक्लोन. सो वी विल कंटिन्यू दिस टुमारो.